Minnesota Health Advocate, and this video is about perms, straightening your hair, etc., etc., letting you know the health conditions that come along with slapping that creamy crap into your child's dome, their crown, and also to you. This natural phase isn't people just, oh, I don't want perms anymore, let me just be natural. No, this natural phase is because we're beginning to wake up. We are snapping out of it, and we must know that perms are killing us. It isn't just, oh, whatever your hair preference is. No, it's killing you. The moment that the perm touches your scalp, enters your bloodstream, it is giving you fibroids, cancer, all type of disease. It's just linked to degenerating the whole uterus. So if you want babies, if you don't want cancer, if you don't want to suffer with fibroids, stop straightening your hair. And let me ask you this. If one group of people on the whole entire planet has this type of hair, wouldn't that make them unique? Why is it that we refer to unique as being that one class of thing only when it comes to your hair? Oh, I can't do anything with it. I don't know how to manage it. Learn how. Because the other way you're going is killing you. So you can begin to learn how to manage your hair. And then it's almost as if you're insulting the creator. You came here with this type of hair. He messed up? Not even he. Excuse me. The creator messed up? The creator was like, excuse this one batch of people right here. I'm just gone. Make their hair completely different from every other race on the planet, but it's just a defect. No, I don't think so. Your uniqueness in your hair, do you understand that you are the only race on the planet that can wear your hair any type of way you desire? Anyway, your hair is the only hair that can stand up. You know why? Because your hair is an antenna. Because it is downloading messages from the sun. Look it up. As crazy as you may think it sounds in your little matrix because you don't want to believe anything, it's 100% accurate. You know how the antenna in the back of the TV stands up? That would be your hair. So what happens is your hair coils. And once your hair coils, it's able to stand up into a bush and it's able to be an antenna downloading and receiving messages from the sun. That is the way it works. And then look at what you're doing to little girls. So you say, oh, you came out wrong, baby. We're going to slap this in so that our hair can look like everyone else's. And then you wonder why these young ladies have low self-esteem. You did that the moment that you told her that her hair wasn't good enough and that it wasn't accepted and that she had to change the texture of it, disconnecting her from nature, disconnecting her from receiving her downloads from the sun, disconnecting her from being oneness with the earth as she is supposed to be. You did that. You started that child off like that. That's your fault. And I'm just saying it was all of our faults because we didn't know at first. I'm a mom, went through the same thing. Well, I never gave my kids perm, but that's another story. I went through the same type of issues with health and all this. So when I say this and I be hard on you, this isn't because I'm judging you. This is because I'm trying to instill in you this urgency to let it all go, to get out of this matrix, to wake up, to stop perming your kids' hair, to stop killing them. You have to understand, even ladies, you go and get your hair braided down to your scalp. I want to show you how mentally ill we've become. And then you go buy another woman's hair and sew it onto your head. That is a mental illness. I don't care what you say. I don't care how you feel about it. You have to be mentally sick to believe that's okay. Why? Why are we doing that? And then you're blocking your crown, your hair, from getting any sun. So you actually go years without your hair ever seeing sun. Do you understand that it is a whole cycle? We need water. Your hair needs water. Your hair needs sun. Just as you do. So when you block that and you put another woman's mat, hanging mat on your head, you can't receive downloads anyway. You can't receive the messages that you need from the sun. Your hair doesn't prosper. Why my hair doesn't grow? Because it doesn't see sun, honey. Because because it doesn't see water, honey, because your diet is poor, honey, because you don't drink any water, because you're inside all day, sweetie. That's what we need to understand. We need to come back to who we are. Your hair is the only hair that can stand up. Why is that? Why isn't that awesome to you? Why is that something that hurts you? Come on, you have to realize what you're doing. And if you don't care, at least save the kids. Because they do matter, and they are the upcoming generation, okay? And they're going to need to be prepared and know the things that we're saying. So with that being said, stop putting the death on your child's crown. Stop. Stop putting that weave in your hair. Y'all making fun of natural women. And it doesn't make sense because under you wearing another woman's hair, that's funny. That's funny that you went and bought another woman's hair. So don't make fun of the natural. Don't make fun of it. Because underneath that, you're missing your size. None of that's going to prosper. None of that's going to grow if you don't nourish it correctly. So with that being said, guys, it's time to go back to who you are. You have forgotten who you are. The lipstick, the makeup, it's all killing you. All of it, every single piece of it is chemicals. It's chemicals, ladies. You're looking like clowns out here. Y'all not even pretty like that. I see women who are stunning women, and they're hiding behind goop on their faces. Goops, and women say, oh, you're gonna let me be me. I put this on my face for me. Why? Why every morning do you dress up like a clown? You're hiding your face. Because what, it enhances you? Now, if you believe that, that's the problem right there. That's a problem right there if you believe that makeup enhances you. Because your soul, the brightness inside of your soul is supposed to enhance the physical. Not makeup. Then they're telling you, you're making yourself up. Then it becomes fake eyelash. Y'all going too far. What you want the man to be attracted to? Fake eyelashes, fake hair, fake nails, fake the perfume. Do you understand that every single person has a pheromone? A pheromone is a body scent, okay? Pheromone attracts you to another being. So if that man is attracted to the way you smell, he is attracted to your pheromone, and that's what attracts him to you. The moment you put on perfume, which is a chemical, watered down, whatever, chemical, you're putting a chemical on you, he's attracted to that smell, not you. So every day of every point in your life, you always gotta wear perfume. He isn't attracted to who you are. He's attracted to the pheromone that's coming from the artificial perfume. That wasn't even made for you, by the way. I won't even get into that. But with that being said, ladies, be who you are. And then how I hear a lot of people alone. Men are alone. Women are alone. And they're saying they can't find anybody. They keep attracting these bad men or these bad women. Honey, men, you need to understand that you need to become the best you that you can become. Perfect you to 1,000%. And then you'll attract exactly that. But when you have things inside you that you're working on, you're going to attract those defects that are made as well. So you need to work on you to every extent that you can work on you. And then when you become 1,000% of you, you'll attract that 1,000% of a mate. Okay? And that doesn't come with, how can he be attracted to who you truly are with all that on your face? Or another woman's hair on your head? Or someone else's perfume on your scent? You're covering up who you are. Who are you? Do you even know who you are? Cherish yourself. Love yourself. Become who you can be. With that being said, if you have any information, questions on anything that I said, please email me. Please message me. Please comment down below. You guys, make sure you have a beautiful day. I love all of you today. I'm Crystal the Health Advocate.